If you thought the last episode of Pokemon was good, you ain't seen nothing yet. So this episode picks up right where the last one left off. And as expected, Operation Tempest is still in motion, and Meloetta is still trapped. Giovanni then commands the Reveal Glass to summon the three powers, which of course is the three legendary Pokemon. And from the way it looks, there is no stopping him. Cynthia, Iris, and the others are on the way to the temple, but they've got a long way to go. They then see a beam of light piercing the sky, and Wrigley, whatever his name is, pretty much states the obvious, how Team Rocket was never after Meloetta, but how they're going to control it to draw out the three legendary Pokemon in order to take over Unova. He then explains how there have been many attempts to get that power since ancient times. Wow. All these years, nothing's changed. Meloetta's song and the reveal glass all in the wrong hands means Giovanni will be able to use the legendary Pokemon to control even the forces of nature and cause any natural disaster he wants. Not good. We then see them make their appearance, Tornadus, Thundurus, and Landorus. And right away, Giovanni doesn't waste any time and commands the reveal glass to show their second form. Ash Ketchum then decides that he's not going to sit around anymore and has his Pikachu use Iron Tail non-stop, breaking them free from the barrier they were trapped in. But why didn't Ash do that before Giovanni summoned the legendary Pokemon? I don't know, but better late than never, I guess. Ash and Pikachu then attempt to help Meloetta, and not only do they get hit by Jesse and James' Pokemon's powerful attacks, but they get knocked off a cliff. Damn! Fortunately for them, Golark was nearby, and he saved them just in time. Ash then has a talk with Cynthia, Cylon, Iris, and Wrigley, telling them what Team Rocket's plan is. And after that, all Ash's friends go on the attack by sending out their Pokemon. Then of course, Ash works his way up the stairs in hopes of rescuing Meloetta. And good God, what is with Giovanni? It's like he's possessed or something. We then see the other forms of the legendaries, and I don't recall ever seeing Giovanni this mad. Unbelievable. Now that he has complete control of these Pokemon, he orders Tornadus, Landorus, and Thundurus to use their powers to devastate the Unova region. But before they can do that, they'll have to get through Pansage, Unpheasant, Dragonite, Garchomp, Pikachu, and Golurk. Let the battle begin. So Dragonite gets a head start and tries to fend off the legendaries by himself. And although he put up a good fight, Dragonite got owned pretty quickly. And just when Thundurus attempted to finish him off, Iris tried to block the attack, then Pikachu blocked the attack for both of them. Giovanni then commands the legendaries to show their true power. How can it get any worse than that? All the Pokemon are taken out with a combined attack by the legendaries. And right after they fall in the water, the legendaries freeze the entire ocean with ease, along with the cities in Unova. And people said that Team Rocket versus Team Plasma was bad? Come on! This is Operation Doomsday right here! But are the Pokemon trapped down there forever? Not at all. They manage to escape and launch a second attack on the legendaries. Then the moment of truth arrives, when Ash reaches the top of the temple once again, saying that he's going to take back Meloetta, and launches a direct attack on Giovanni with Pikachu's Electro Ball, which ends up being a mega-sized Electro Ball. How is this possible? Thanks to the attack that Pikachu took and absorbed from Thundurus, that gave it just enough power to take down Team Rocket, along with Giovanni as well. This was a massive attack, so I'm thinking, who could survive an attack like that? Only Team Rocket. Meloetta is then set free, and already, things are looking up. Then the unthinkable happens. Giovanni gets up, and he has a very strange mark on his head, and his eyes are just bloodshot as hell. Then from out of nowhere, he claims that he lives for destruction. Damn! Giovanni's definitely gone mad now. And at this point, Jesse and James know that something's off. And this guy, whatever his name is, who looks like Dr. Wily's older cousin, says that he has no idea what's going on. Wrigley then explains everything, how the three legendaries have the power of nature, and that whoever summons them using Meloetta, it acts like a balance to maintain them, so they don't lose control. But since Meloetta is free, the evil inside Giovanni has completely taken over him, and now he wants to destroy everything. Jesse and James then take the ultimate risk to save Giovanni, tackling him from behind, and right after, he turns back to normal and realizes what happened. And right after that, orders a retreat. That is a first. They then take their leave, and Jesse and James feel that Ash's Pikachu is very special indeed. Huh. If Ash wins the Unova League, it'll be special then. Ridley quickly decides to calm down the legendary Pokemon, making a wish to the reveal glass. And Meloetta does what it does best, sings its song, calm downs the legendary Pokemon, and returns them to their original form. Thank goodness. And on the Team Rocket plane, Giovanni realized that his actions almost cost him his own life. This was also a big surprise, and something else I never thought I'd hear him say. And you've got to wonder if he's going to leave Team Rocket or disband the group. With Team Plasma scheduled to take part in the next season, looks like Team Rocket is finally going to retire. Or I could be wrong, and Jesse and James will be back. And in closing, the episode ends with one last goodbye from Ridley and Meloetta to Ash and his friends, with Oshawott shedding many tears that it'll miss them dearly. And there goes another Pokemon that Ash could have caught easily to help him win the Unova League. Why couldn't the producers have Meloetta stick with Ash until the Unova League was over, then have it go back with Ridley? Ash and Meloetta clearly have a bond just like him and Pikachu. So wouldn't it make more sense to have Meloetta help him win the Unova League, then go home? Oh well. Anyway, great episode, very entertaining, and lots of fun to watch. All these years passed, and Pokemon is still going strong. I love it.